Are you looking for the best export settings for Adobe's Premiere Pro? Maybe you want your images to look a little bit more crisp and a little bit nicer. In this video, I'm gonna give you my export settings for Premiere Pro, and that video is gonna start now. Hi, my name is Brian the Camera Guy, and on my channel, I review Sony camera gear, along with give you tips and tricks on how to make your image quality look even better. If that's something that you're into, consider hitting that subscribe button and that bell notification so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. Now, first and foremost, sometimes the biggest factor in your video quality can be the lens and the camera that you use. Most of the time, that's gonna help create some really crispy image for you. But let's say you wanna go ahead and you want to up your game. And a lot of that has to do with the export settings that you're using when you're using Premiere Pro. Sometimes the best way to improve your image quality is with lighting and with camera gear. So I'll go ahead and I'll link up some videos up in the cards above on some of my recommendations for not only cameras, but also for lighting that's gonna help improve your video quality. But let's say you've done all that and you still can't get your image just looking just right. So I'm gonna go ahead and give you my export settings to help give you that really crispy video. So let's go ahead, we'll jump into Premiere Pro and go from there. All right, so here we are in Premiere Pro. As you can see, I do have a file set up right now, ready to go. I got some video here. I shoot everything in 16:9 aspect ratio. But when I export to YouTube, generally I like to do a 2:1 aspect ratio. Now the reason for that is most of the time people are using their cell phones to view your videos. And I wanna go ahead and take up the whole screen real estate. So how do I do that? First, what I do is I go ahead and I drop my footage into the timeline. And then I come up here to sequence and I change my sequence settings from 3840 by 2160. I will usually just take this 3840 and divide it by two and go 1920. And then once you do that, it's gonna tell you that it's gonna resize. Of course, go ahead and hit okay. And now if you notice, the image looks a little bit more stretched. That's the first step that I do to make it look absolutely great on any cell phone. Now the next step is we wanna go ahead and export. So what we do is we go File, Export, Media. And of course, here's your media dropdown box. Now if you notice, because we changed the scaling of the video, you have these black bars on the top of the bottom. So if you just go ahead and export the way it is, it's going to export with those black bars. I'll show you how to fix that in a second. First, what we wanna do is we wanna drop down our format. We wanna pick H.264. And now if you notice, those black bars are gone. Now it's gonna match your high bit rate right now. But what I like to do is I like to drop this down. I like to go to YouTube 4K down here at the bottom. And this is my starting point. Now, once again, those black bars are back because it's using that 16:9 ratio. Go ahead and obviously pick where you wanna export this. So I'm gonna call this test footage. Now I have my file name ready to go. I'm gonna come down here and what I'm gonna wanna do is I'm gonna wanna click this button right here, and that's going to stop it from when I change one of these numbers from changing the other number. Now remember, our current aspect ratio is 3840 by 1920. So I'm going to change this to 1920. And if you notice, the 3840 stayed the same, but this changed to 1920. And once again, I've gotten rid of those black bars. I'm going to scroll down a little bit. I'm going to hit maximum render in depth. I'm going to use hardware encoding, and I want to use level 5.1. 5.1 or 5.2 are going to be your two 4K settings. I recommend just leaving it at whatever Premiere is picked. Scroll down a little bit further. And the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the VBR one pass. I'm going to change that to two pass. And now it gives you two target frames. I like to set this one at 50 and then set the maximum at 60. And that means that it's gonna try and target 50 megabits per second, but it's gonna try and maximize that and get up to 60 megabytes per second. So scrolling down, I leave everything else the same, but then I also click this maximum render quality. And then once I have that all set, I go ahead and I add it to the queue. I never export through Premiere Pro just in case it ever crashes. I always do it through Media Encoder. I find that that helps get the best quality and that helps make my computer run a lot smoother. So now, as you can see, we have our video file ready to go. We just hit play and everything is running and rendering. All right, so now let's say you want to save this thing as a custom preset. So this way you never have to go back and do the settings again. So now you have everything all set up, ready to go. So what you want to do is go ahead and click here, save preset. Go ahead and name it YouTube export. Traditionally, I don't check any of these boxes. Go ahead and save it. And now from your dropdown, right at the very top, will be YouTube Export. And we'll go ahead and put in all your custom settings. So there you go. That's how I do my exporting to give me the crispest, best looking image that I possibly can get when exporting from Premiere Pro to YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, make sure you use that comment box down below. If you like this video, I'm sure you're gonna like the video on the screen now about another way to improve your video quality. Go ahead and click on that video and I'll see you on that video next. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Brian, out.